just a number. What's the first thing that comes to your mind when I say number 9?
9? I don't focus on numbers, but I know my friend's birthday is on 9th.
Basically, 9 represents long lasting and it is a very significant number in our mythology.
So the number 9, according to my views, if we take it in a good way, it is good, and if we take it in a bad way, it is bad.
9 is just a number.
Well, third gender people are comes to my mind when I hear the number 9, because you know, people used to call them with that number. I don't know the reason why.
Number 9 is just a number, but for today, it's my enemy.
9 is just a number, and it's 9 o'clock now.
So guys, let me be very clear that 9 is not just a number in the number system. It's beyond our imaginations. Have you ever wondered why the human pregnancy duration is 9 months? Why the solar system is bound by 9 planets? Why we celebrate Navaratri, the 9 auspicious Ratri? Be it Navaratri or Navagraha, number 9 has a very significant role to play from the time immemorial. Have you ever noticed that number 9 is kind of amazing and magical? Well, if you still believe 9 is just a number, then prepare yourself to get amazed, because in this video, I shall reveal you the magic behind the mysterious number 9. 9 is not just a number, it's a number of magic. It's a mysterious number. It's a sacred number. In Hindu religion, number 9 is very important. Keeping the importance of number 9, Rishi Vyas created 9 Puranas, 108 Upanishads. According to Indian mythology, we have 4 Yugas, the Satya Yuga, the Treta Yuga, the Dwapara Yuga and the Kali Yuga. The Satya Yuga consisted of 172,800 years. Adding up all of these numbers sums up to number 18. And again, 18 is 1 plus 8, which sums up to number 9. The Treta Yuga consisted of 12,96,000 years. The Dwapara Yuga consisted of 8,64,000 years. And the Kali Yuga consists of 4,32,000 years. Adding up all of these numbers sums up to number 9. The average distance between the Earth and Sun is 9,29,55,807 miles. Adding up all of these numbers sums up to number 45. And again, 45 is 4 plus 5, which sums up to number 9. According to Hindu astronomy, there are 27 constellations in our galaxy, and each one of them has 4 directions. When 27 is multiplied by 4, we get 108. And again, 108 sums up to number 9. The number 108 covers the whole of the galaxy. Have you ever been asked to chant a mantra for 108 times? The obvious question that arises is, what is the importance of 108? Why is it holy and sacred? Why the malas have 108 beads? Why is it so important in our Indian rituals? Well, the answer is Vedic cosmology. Our ancient Vedic sages who designed the modern numeral system were renowned mathematicians. According to Vedic cosmology, number 108 forms the basis of creation of the universe, and it forms the basis of whole of our existence. Number 108 is a number which resonates throughout the universe. Let me give you the abstract meaning of 108. 1 stands for supreme truth or God's consciousness. 0 stands for nothing or emptiness. 8 stands for infinity or eternity. Rotate 8 by 90 degrees either ways, you get the symbol of infinity. Astronomical evidences on the auspiciousness of number 108. Distance of Sun is 108 times that of Earth. Distance between Earth and Sun is 108 times the dia of the Sun. Distance between Earth and Moon is 108 times the dia of the Moon. Therefore, number 108 covers the entire galaxy and holds a very special place in Vedic astronomy. Therefore, 108 sums up to number 9.
There are a lot of things which are unseen to our naked eyes. Number 9 is one among them. Coming to Pythagoras' theorem. Pythagoras' theorem helps us build squares and rectangles. builders use it for building buildings, keeping windows and doors closed. So basically Pythagoras theorem deals with 90 degrees, and 9 plus 0 is again 9.
Have you ever noticed that the sum of all the interior angles of a triangle is 180 degrees, and the circle and square is 360 degrees, and pentagon is 540 degrees? Adding up all of these numbers sums up to number 9. So the result is common, that is number 9. When 9 is multiplied by any number, it always reproduces itself. 9 remains intact when multiplied by any number. And if you bring down the result to one digit, it is always number 9. Think of any digit and add number 9 to it. The result you get will always be the same number. That's the beauty of number 9. Also, number 9 has a very crucial role to play in our daily lives. If you add up all the minutes in a day, it sums up to number 9. There are 1440 minutes in each day. 86,400 seconds are required to complete a cycle of 24 hours. And if you add up all of these numbers, it sums up to number 9. An average healthy person takes about 21,600 breaths in a day. And it sums up to number 9. 9 has a very significant role to play from the time immemorial. The creators of Indian classical arts found these 9 emotions or 9 expressions, also referred to as the Navarasa. The theory of Navarasa forms the aesthetic underlining of all forms of Indian classical dance.
I have learned from my elders that number 9 is related to mythology and historical epics. Some say it's a sacred number. What's your ideology on this?
Number 9 is greatly associated with our historical epics too. Take for instance the Mahabharata. Mahabharata is associated with number 18 in several ways. Mahabharata has 18 parvas. Bhagavad Gita has 18 chapters. Mahabharata was Jaya. According to Sanskrit Sankhya system, Jaya is 18. The architect of the war, Sri Krishna's Yadavas caste, had 18 clans. The army number of divisions which took place in the war were 18. 11 divisions of Kauravas and 7 divisions of Pandavas. Therefore, number 18 sums up to number 9. The war between Devas and Asuras went for 18 years. The fight between Rama and Ravana went for 18 months. The war between Kauravas and Pandavas went for 18 days. The Devas took about 10,800 days to churn the ocean of milk into Amrita. The gems are 9, the Navaratnas. The scholars in the kingdom of Vikramaditya were called Navaratnas.
How about Bible? What does Bible say about number 9?
The number 9 represents the divine completeness and conveys the meaning of finality. Christ died on the 9th hour of the day in order to make a way of salvation open to everyone. A special day considered by many of the Jews to be the holiest of the year begins on the sunset of the 9th day of the 7th Hebrew month. 9 also represents the fruit of God's Holy Spirit, which is forgiveness, goodness, joy, gentleness, kindness, long-suffering, love, peace, and self-control. In Islam too, the significance of number 9 is underlined, which is almost similar to the ancient Indian thought, the Sanatana Dharma, which speaks about the 9 Randras or the Navarandras, and also the 9-month gestation period for birth, which is of course common to all human beings.
What about music?
According to Pythagoras, all the musical notes are created using the concept of sacred geometry. And surprisingly, the result of each chord of musical frequency produces the result as number 9. He explains the origin of sacred geometry from the concept of seed of life. And it is very surprising to know that the concept of sacred geometry is also embedded in our DNA. I'm sure you must be thinking that all of this facts is a coincidence. Is it just a coincidence? No, there is no coincidence in life. The world was created with utmost accuracy. 9 is not just a number, it's a number of heaven. It represents completeness and fulfillment. 9 is a number of good leadership and wisdom. And 9 is a number of Brahma, the creator. Number 9 is often associated with a divine connotation in the mystical thought and religions across the globe from ancient times. 9 is the universe itself, the energy, the vibration and the frequency. The energy and meaning of each of the numbers is different, whether we see them in the numerology charts or wonder why they keep reappearing in our lives. It's important to know what they mean so we can understand the messages they are sending us. 9 is not just a number.